Good morning and welcome to day 11 of Vlogmas. I haven't mentioned all week what I'm wearing because I've quite got out of this like vlogging lark, and I'd like to think that I can do a little bit more vlogging next year, because I know a lot of people have said to me that my channel is not coming up for Vlogmas for loads of people this year, and it's probably because I don't regularly upload apart from doing the lives. But anyway, yeah, I'm wearing my toaster sweater, and I haven't made a toaster sweater for ages because I go through like phases of making the same pattern over and over again, as you know well. And I made loads of toaster sweaters, and then I moved on to the Charlie sweater. I made the Saraya sweater, so I was wearing that a few evenings ago. So that was what I was wearing when I did like headlamp demonstration. So as one of the lovely ladies in the comments said, I think it was day 9, if today's 11, day 9 was a bit of a roller coaster. So it started off with tears for Lola and then laughing at my headlamp. So that kind of sums up my day, really, to be perfectly honest. So yeah, I'm wearing my toaster sweater, and as I'm wearing it, I want to make more of them. Do you ever do that? So this is, I think, no, this wasn't the one I did for a sew-along. I did a sew-along for one. I've probably worn that one to death. Can't even remember what the one that was. But this is just a cotton jersey. And actually, for me, I think at the moment, as I'm acclimatizing to this different climate, this is probably perfect for me. This feels really comfy now and just right for, yeah, the weather. It's quite cold out today, but it's actually really warm here in the shop. Even though I don't have the temperature set very high, but it just seems to stay really cozy, which is absolutely brilliant, because I worried a little bit about it, about the building, because it was built in 2009. It's been really well maintained. Like, the shop was perfection when I moved in here. It had been repainted clean to an inch of its life. It was immaculate. The landlords put down a floor for me, so I cannot complain. They've been amazing. They put in new lighting for me and everything, because the lighting here was really like yellow, so they put in brand new lighting. I've digressed. What I was worried about was, because all the windows in Poundbury are timber, that I thought, well, there's going to be a lot of heat loss through the windows. I did have quite a gap on the back door, but they fixed that for me, which was great. But no, it seems to be, it really keeps the heat. I have my gas with British Gas, and only recently I found out where to read my meter. So it has been estimated for ages, and the bills were really, really low. So I was kind of worried that when I would go to do the reading that I would have like a massive bill, but actually the estimate was like spot on, which was just brilliant. So yeah, that was great. That was, you know, one of those jobs you think, oh, I'm not gonna read that because that's gonna be such a shock. I'm not gonna like the outcome. And then I put it off, and then I do it, and it's like, oh, that was fine. My window cleaners have to arrive. I was thinking, what is that noise? I think it's the window cleaner. Now, normally the window cleaner sends me a text and says, your windows need cleaning. But he didn't, unless I missed the text. But the windows were actually cleaned the day before snow a couple of weeks ago. So I know for a fact, actually, that was the 18th of November. And it was like a waste of time them getting cleaned, because they were just completely and utterly filthy after the snow. So I'm actually really pleased now he's cleaning the windows today. So yeah, I'm actually making up knickers kits this morning. I'm almost there. I've cut all the fabric. Now I'm on the last run of cutting the elastic. I'm actually talking and like counting, which is I definitely got out of bed the right side this morning. So I do love doing the knickers kits. I'm very sad in that my normal supplier of knickers elastic doesn't seem to have knickers elastic at the moment. So whatever I have now is what I have. So I'm going to have to source a new supplier next year. Can you actually believe how long the phase of knickers, making your own knickers, has lasted. Now, I genuinely thought it was a phase, but it doesn't appear to be. So Tilly and the Buttons brought out their knickers pattern, and I think that's when the whole phase for me of doing the knickers kits kind of kicked off. And myself and Caroline put a couple together, and we were kind of thinking, well, these might sell. We'll try it, because, you know, we just give it a go. And they just shot out the door. And every time I put up knickers kits, I think, oh, I'm going to be left with them this time now. You know, you've made too many. They're going to be left on the shelf. People have got out of the whole knickers making phase. Because, like, bag making is just so popular now, isn't it? So, yeah. But no, they're really, really popular, and I get a great kick out of making them. So I've all the fabric cut. This is the slowest part for me, because it's not the cutting of the fabric, that's dead easy. It's the, like, what'll go with this and what'll go with this, and have I done this one before, and I want to do something different. And I've got so many lovely cotton jerseys at the minute. And so, yeah, I've them done. I tend to go for all the colours, so I seem to have a lot of, like, for red elastic at the moment. But I thought, well, it is the Christmassy season, who wouldn't like some nice red pants for Christmas? And then I remember, of course, that I really should do like a neutral pair. So I've got some nice, like, neutrally pinky ones there. And then I thought, well, I better do some white ones. So I've got some white ones, and I've got some black ones. I've got bright pink. I'm talking about the elastic. So I cut these little templates on card. I've got my little template, and I've actually, do you know what? I've written template on it, because more often than not, I use the template, can't find the template, and then have to make a new template. So I've actually written it on it. And so in all of the kits, I do two types of elastic. So there's 10 meters in all. Sometimes there can be a little more, because if there's a bit left on the roll, I just throw that in. But there's generally 10 meters, and you can kind of use it whatever way you want. Winding it onto these cards is a little bit of a slow part of it, but I was anxious to get these done, because it's getting very close to Christmas, and I thought, well, they'd make great little stocking fillers, wouldn't they? So I want to get them, yeah, I want to get them done. What I do now is I make a couple of each kit. So originally, when I was making knickers kits, I might have only had like one set, and kind of learned the hard way, to be honest, because each of these then have to be photographed, uploaded to the website, and basically if I only put up one, I take a photo, load it up, it's sold, that's it, it's gone. So yeah, I'm trying to be more what do they say, work smarter, not harder. So I've got maybe three or four sets of each of them, and I always like to think, I like to kind of make a bet with myself. Myself and Caroline used to always do this. I'd say, Caroline, right, which one do you think is actually going to be the most popular? Which one's going to sell out first? And she would more often than not be right, because I would predict as well. And it would normally be what Caroline thinks would sell out first. I have a kind of a feeling this time which one is going to go. This one here. I'm feeling that could possibly be the most popular, or I've got a red one as well. But maybe that's just because they're my most favourites. I don't know. Then, yeah, they have to be photographed, put up on the website, and then they have to be like boxed. I also have to cut the white cotton for the gussets yet. So I think I'm actually well on track now to get this done by 10 o'clock. Wind the rest of these. I think this is it then. Put everything away. Take each of them, photograph them. I am going to put one each into a box, and then tomorrow I actually have help. So I've got a lady called Emma who's coming in to help me tomorrow and Friday, which is great. We're going to see how it works for her and see if she likes helping out. And then she's going to be with me then, hopefully, next year. So building the little Beyond the Pink Door team as we go. So that would be great, because Emma can do that while the shop is open, because I often feel that the desk here is empty on Thursdays and Fridays. Sometimes Thursdays are not too busy, but more often they're really busy in the shop, and I feel something else could be happening back here. So yeah, Emma's going to start doing Thursdays and Fridays, and yeah, learn as we go. So she sews, which is great, and she's never worked in a fabric shop before, so she has lots to learn, and that'll be good, because she has skills that I don't have, and I have knowledge that I can pass on to her. So yeah, it'll be good. So it'll be interesting now, having somebody here with me. So hopefully next year I will extend the Beyond the Pink Door team maybe to somebody else on Mondays and Tuesdays as well. So that'll be good. Still finding my feet, still unpacking, but yeah, little by little. As they say, Rome wasn't built in a day. Beyond the Pink Door was certainly not built in a day. So he's around to the front now. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. I've got 5 of these kind of archy windows, and then I have 2 big windows out the front. And yeah, he's doing the front one now, so it's great. Great. And that's definitely one of those work smarter, not harder things. I'm not going to clean those windows. I'd rather have somebody come along once a month, clean the windows. He has it done in very little time, and it would take me the day to do it. So yeah, so I'm going to crack on with these. Then I am going to check on a few replies from emails that I made this morning, or sent this morning, because of course I send my emails before a lot of people are up, and checking. Oh, that's him, he's done. So I heard the letterbox go, so that's him putting his card in the door to tell me, pay for your windows. So that's great. Anyway, God, I've waffled for 17 minutes. Oh, I'm so sorry. I may have to take some of this out to quicken it up. So I've just managed to get all the knickers kits onto the website. And rather than call them just knickers kit 1, 2, 3, A, B or C or whatever, I decided I was going to be really imaginative today. And it dawned on me that Santa has 9 reindeers. And I actually had 9 different types of knickers kits. So they're all named after Santa's reindeers today. So it is 4:15, and the postman is due at 4 o'clock to pick up, which is great. It's actually really fun because when I was in Ireland, the postman picked up at 4 o'clock in our area as well. So yeah, it's funny. Just one of those stupid things. So I had a great day. I've done the sew along for the crescent bag, and this is the one I've made. So it's, as I describe in the sew along, it's plain on the outside, well, plainish, and it's party on the inside. So I put this really fun lining in it, and it was actually really, yeah, really nice to make. I was interrupted so many times today between the postman, delivery men, people coming to the door thinking I was open today. Yeah, it's just been one of those days, but yeah, it's all done now. I had my friend Wendy in today, so that was amazing. So she came with a card, which is very apt for what was in her present to me. So she brought me some mince pies, and beautifully packaged as ever. I have tasted them, they're amazing, as I knew they would be. So I got this lovely little present today. So this is, oh, that's her booty, this is a little ceramic ornament that Wendy has made, and look at that, how cute is that? So yeah, they're gorgeous. Jason will see some of them. She's given me quite a few of them. Actually, I'm going to tie a knot in the handle because I've had a few today. They're so nice. And I had a lovely card put through the letterbox today. I heard the card going through the letterbox. I ran up to the door, but I missed Jenny. And I got this gorgeous card. And I know, I was looking at it thinking, I bet she's made that. And yeah, it says handmade by Jenny. So how lovely. Isn't that just beautiful? Oh, God. So yeah, I've had Wendy and I missed Jenny, unfortunately. What else did I get today? I had loads of messages today. So apparently Mindy was having great fun in the back of my video yesterday evening as I unboxed my advent calendar. Totally missed it. But yeah, that cat is determined to get into the tree. What else I've had? So I heard from Donna today. So hello to Scout again. So Scout was watching me again last night. She thinks that he likes my my voice or my accent. So that's really cool. That's top fan is Scout. I also had a few messages from people saying that, yeah, being in a funk is such a thing. So yeah, Monday I was in a funk. And do you know, I will admit, Monday's vlog I thought was actually so miserable that I wasn't going to put it up. But yeah, I had quite a few messages saying today, do you know, sometimes I wake up and I don't feel great. And I'm so glad that you actually showed reality on your vlog. So yeah. I'm glad I'm one of those people who kind of looks back and goes, oh, I shouldn't have done that. I overanalyze and overthink things at times. But yeah, so that was really nice to get those messages today. So yeah, it's been a really lovely day. The only thing I have going out today now are the kids' advent calendars. So thrilled about those. Postman will be here in a couple of minutes. Then I'm off to the gym for 4:30. And then I'm going to go home. I'm going to have a lot of editing to do because I really want to get this bag so along edited and up. So yeah, really looking forward to doing. I'm actually really looking forward to editing that later on. I've done quite a few videos today of talking. So I think I'm going to just trash a couple of them because the vlog is going to be way too long. And you'll have all lost the will to live listening to me. And yeah, I think that'll be it for the evening. Can't wait to see what Jazz and Wow Advent Calendar has for me this evening. I'm actually so glad that I leave it until the evening because it's such a thing to look forward to. It really is. I've caught up on a lot of Vlogmases today as well. So while I was doing the Knickers kits today, I caught up on quite a few Vlogmases. I've commented on a few, but I've watched some back to back. So, oh, there's so many this year and they're all so good. So yeah, caught up on quite a few today. I have to say, it is so nice to see Michelle Sewing Bunny back doing Vlogmas. I have so missed her smiley face and her little cat's bums. So it's so nice to see her back. Her vlogs are always so like heartwarming and homely. They're lovely. So yeah, thrilled to see her back. So before I start waffling on, I am going to go. Something else just came into my head and went out just as fast. Woo, over the head and back. Gone. No idea what that was. But anyway, see you later for the opening of my advent calendar and to see what the cats got today and if they got something today. So it is Jasmine Wow Advent Calendar time. I've got day 11 ready. I've checked the date on my phone and it is definitely day 11. I'm not going to make that mistake again. And I've actually remembered. So in the last clip, I was trying to think of what the other thing I was going to tell you all. And it was that the prediction I made earlier on about what was going to be the most popular in the Knickers kit, I was right. So it's the one called Blitzen. And so I think that's actually the first time that I've ever predicted right. So yeah, the Knickers kits are going down a storm today, which is great. So yeah, before I make this vlog of a length that nobody wants to watch, I'm going to open day 11. So it's flat. Feels like a star. Oh, let's just open it. I love all the different colored bags as well. It's a snowflake and it's glittery and it's pink. Ooh, now that's actually so nice. That, I was just thinking I'll put it straight on the tree, but actually I'm going to bring that to work and put it on the tree at work because it's pink and it's sparkly. Oh, that's so cute. That's so cute. This calendar is just, have you guessed? I so like it. I'm so enjoying it. So yeah, I'm not going to waffle on for too long. I've already cut out 5 minutes of waffle from this morning's waffle. And there may be more by the time I finish doing the editing, but I am going to upload Jason's videos next. I haven't watched them. I've just received them through Messenger. So I'm going to pop them in next. So from me, it's goodbye until tomorrow, which is day 12. And I'll leave you with Jason.
Hiya. Well, today's interesting. It appears that my boat was going to be 2 o'clock today. It's now been moved to 8 o'clock tonight. And boring long story, but going to Europe now, which Southern Ireland obviously is, new GMR numbers, PBN numbers, and I don't currently have a GMR number. So the office is on to that. And so I've got the delights of Fishguard car park for a few hours until such time as I can hopefully get on that boat. So we'll see. So yeah, very interesting day, very dull day. Bit of driving on the boat, no doubt late. I'll see if I can get a bit of coverage on the boat. Not sure if Andrea will get all this today because I'm not going to get the boat until this evening when she's actually doing her editing. So this might have to move into tomorrow and be like a part one, part two, yesterday and today sort of thing. So yeah, an interesting day. Hello, just thought I'd give you a bit of a quick update. Very straightforward day. I am going to get on the ferry. I shall show you a picture of the lorries. We're going to be packed in like sardines. The boat is about 6-7 hours out of time. But I should be over in Southern Ireland by about anywhere between sort of 10 or 11 o'clock tonight. So, you know, it could be a lot worse, has been a lot worse in the past. So at least that way I can find someone to park, get a bit of sleep and then get into tomorrow. So not so bad, just a very lackluster, steady day. So yeah, we're going to get on the boat shortly. So yeah, and apparently the boat's gone from doing what used to be a 4 hour journey to 3.5 hours. And today, 2 hours and 10 minutes. So it just goes to show what they can do when they really have to, doesn't it? So with a bit of luck, he's going to do that tonight. And we're going to get a good crossing. And then we can get into tomorrow, head up to Dublin from the south, which is never a bad thing because apart from meeting a lovely lady in Ireland, I love Ireland. I think it's a really pretty country and I'm quite happy to drive up through Ireland. No problem at all. So I'm more than happy with that. So yeah, all in all, could have been worse, but it's okay. Thank you.